We on the road to 500, yo. Subscribe.
Yo, my people. What's good? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to Patala FC. We are within. And we've reached the end of the season. A good season. A season that's been turned around in terms of Chelsea Football Club. But other teams have fought for the title. Other teams have surprisingly not made the top four. Other teams have surprised us, like Villa, in deserving a top four finish above other clubs like ourselves, to be honest, and Spurs. And Brighton, I think, a bit low. Speaking of Brighton, De Zerbi officially announcing his departure come the end of the season. Quite late in terms of Brighton's announcement, but it makes Man United's final game a bit more interesting, I believe, with the Brighton boys probably feeling like they can show up and ruin the Ten Hag reputation even more. And then Man United have to worry about the FA Cup against Manchester City. But yes, good season in terms of us. We turned it around since the last week of December. I'm happy with our league position. Should Spurs somehow do Spursy things and lose against Sheffield and Chelsea win against Bournemouth, Chelsea could finish the season fifth in the top five. And unfortunately, England just didn't earn the fifth spot for Champions League football, because then we could have been fighting for something. I don't think we're ready for Champions League as a team, so it's fine. Europa might just be the right standard for us to try and develop further. Let's keep it all positive today. Yes, yes. Todd Bowley spoke a bit on Bloomberg Television. I'd love to share my thoughts on his interview. But today, we're jumping into awards. Chelsea boys. So if you're here and you're a Chelsea fan, if the sky is blue, be sure to join the fam. You know what it is. But yes, we jump straight into the awards. So we're going to do 10. 10, yo. So goal of the season, miss of the season, game of the season, most painful game of the season, overachiever, underachiever. We're going to see for number 7, save of the season, moment of the season, as well as player of the season. Let's get it. Your goal of the season, we're going to like skim through because we've witnessed these moments. I'm just going to share my thoughts on a weird season to be a Chelsea fan, but one where we understand where we are, we're progressing. Let's see what the young players bring in terms of joy next season. Goal of the season, for me, Enzo Fernandez free kick against Villa. The FA Cup, very, very clean. Very, very clean goal. Gonna try and put every single moment in terms of video. Let's hope the copyright laws don't kill us. Miss of the season, gonna give it to Nicholas Jackson against Forest. Yeah, made a video about Jackson earlier and I actually put the same clip, and that miss really got to me. Game of the season, I'm gonna say our game at Stamford Bridge against Manchester City. 4-4 thriller. Cole Palmer show there. Him coming out against his former club, you know? Amazing game. I mean, 8 goals says enough, right? Reviewed that game with my boy there. Most painful game of the season. Quite recent, actually. Two contenders, but the winner is definitely the winner. Arsenal 5, Chelsea 0. Yeah, I know, guys. That one. Dizzy. And Anfield. Our visit to Anfield. Definitely a contender. That 4-1 was dizzy. I can't lie. What's next? Overachiever. Nicholas Jackson. I think Nicholas Jackson having 14 Premier League goals. Could have had more. Could have easily been around 20. Even above 20. Cole Palmer got his fair share, of course. But yeah, I think Jackson's had a good first season. If you told me that he would score 17 goals in his first season, we would be in the Carabao Cup final, and he would have played a role in our journey to the Carabao Cup final, and he would have played a major role in where we are in the league as well to some degree. It's a good first season from Jackson. Oof. Chesticles, man. Chest. Oof. Underachiever. It's not fully his fault that he's the underachiever, but I'm going to say Enzo Fernandez. Because Enzo Fernandez was born to be a creative spark, make decisions in terms of forward passing. But many a times he looks lost, or over the season, he's looked like he's not very comfortable doing that job, unless it wasn't his job. Because some games, Enzo's looked like he's a CDM, literally, like he's supposed to just do defensive work, which is fine. Maybe for those games, we forgive him. But his ability as a player, which he showed us glimpses of towards the end of last season, I feel like he could have brought that out a bit more alongside Caicedo in midfield. Even if Gallagher was playing in the 10 role, and now we're seeing that he's actually just better in a deep line position as well. But Enzo Fernandez takes it for me. Yeah. Number 7, I think that's save of the season, I believe. I'm going to give it to Petrovic against Luton. It was a header from Morris, and the reaction time on Petrovic to block it, it was one of those quick De Gea kind of reactions. Yeah, I'm giving De Gea his flowers without knowing there. But yeah, good save from Dodi Petrovic. And he's young. He's gotten better as the season's progressed. If not for Cole Palmer, Petrovic would be that guy that we look at to win some awards here. But we're already like 7 in. So yeah. Number 8. What are we saying? I got a piece of paper if y'all can see. Best. No. Let's actually do this. Let's say best performance of the season. Best performance. I believe Cole Palmer has to take it. Either in the Everton 6-0 or the Middlesbrough 6-1 in the Carabao Cup. And I think I'm going to give it to the Middlesbrough 6-1 because it was the first showing of Cole Palmer's free roaming ability and just how effective it can be for the team. On the day, Enzo also played a bit like forward. He was a bit forward playing and he also got a goal, I think, or possibly a brace, I'm not sure. But yeah, I think Cole Palmer had a great performance against Middlesbrough. And I think it was at Stamford Bridge. We had lost the first leg at the Riverside Stadium. And then we came back and ended 6-2 on aggregate. And we made the final of the Carabao Cup. Yeah, player of the season. Ugh. I just spoke about the player of the season. Cold Palmer. 32 goal contributions this season. Need I say more about Cole Palmer? I'm actually going to judge him next season. Can he keep this consistent? Because he is class. Undeniably. And yeah, moment of the season is our last one. Cole Palmer. When Cole Palmer scored the equalizer for the 4-4 against Manchester City at Stamford Bridge, the celebration in the rain, that's the moment of the season for me. Yeah, that's my personal moment of the season. Would love y'all to share yours. Let's get it, y'all.